Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to our Jurassic World Evolution 2 Park Tours. Today we're going to check out Jurassic Park Sauna, made by Dr. Squatch, otherwise known as Ratsmacker 3050, because Ratsmacker 1 through 3049 were obviously taken. it's a name. And this is a park that's set on Isla Sorna, of course, and the idea is very simply, if Jurassic Park 1993 had worked out, and if people hadn't, you know, been eaten alive and such, and it had become so popular, they decided to open up another park on the neighbouring island on Isla Sorna. So it's kind of, what if Jurassic Park was successful on Sorna, but also some references, and this is why I love it so much, some references to Jurassic Park 3 in particular. I'm sure some Lost World ones and stuff like that in there as well. The park itself is a little bit, not boring or anything, but it's nothing, it's fairly regular looking park, so we're not going to do our usual tour style today because it would take me bloody ages and there's not that much to show. But there's some really, really cool exhibit design choices done here. This is the first mod, blah 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 blah, this is the first downloaded park I've looked at, and I'll link it down below, of course, in the description, where the user has used mods to sell the idea they're trying to do. A lot of people haven't been using mods that much, and it lets you do some pretty cool things. So I'm going to showcase those pretty cool things. We'll have a little proper tour anyway. So this is kind of the this is where I started off anyway. So this will have to be the entrance for now. I've got this really interesting raised up section here. I don't know what this is meant to be per se, but it's funky and I like that about it. There's just some towers kind of overlooking the entirety of the park from this raised area. And again, just being able to do stuff like this with the terrain tools and make these really high ramps is a pretty cool thing. So let's have a little poke around. We've got some dinosaurs over here. Most of them are ones you would find on Sorna. For example, the Pachycephalosaurus, of course, from the game trail in the Lost World Jurassic Park. How you doing, buddy? Feeling sexy? Feeling sexy. over here we have, yeah, so this is, again, this is the kind of thing I really like about this. Let's hop into first person for this. So the Isla Sorna, so this map, there we go, uses the expanded islands mod, which means you can build in a lot wider area. And on this map, on Isla Sorna, what that means is you can build in places like this. This, of course, is meant to be the visitor center worker village. That's more the word you'd use, worker village, in the end of the Lost World Jurassic Park. And because of expanded maps, what you can do is actually build an exhibit, as you can see, with velociraptors right here in the worker village. So if we have a look, yeah, we've got our Jurassic Park 3 raptor. Personally, I would have used the tiger raptors, but I can see why. I mean, it could be the building from Jurassic Park 3, to be fair. The lab. But either way, we've got a Jurassic Park 3 velociraptors, and we've got the worker village kind of thing. You see, these are actually some of the vehicles. That's the expanded decorations as well. We have a Jurassic Park 3 male, a couple more of them there, and there's our female, our matriarch of the group. And because what they've done, as you can see as you look around, they've put invisible fences around the borders of the buildings. The raptors are actually running around in between all of these buildings, treating them like they actually exist. If we, one day when we get invisible fences back as a mod, like full-on invisible fences, this would be even cooler. But the fact that you can now make a habitat out of this, I think is really, really cool stuff. And yeah, so I'm a big fan of that. I think that's a really nice idea, actually. Showcase all that there. So you can, I mean, obviously, this wasn't meant to be viewed from the back, quite clearly, but, you know, you get up close and the textures are all a bit of a mess. But it's a very cool reference, all the same. And I love that they've thrown some vehicles in there to kind of sell the idea that it was a functioning area of the park. And this is the kind of thing why I really like this map. So I'm going to show a few more things just like that. Over here we have, well, let's check this one out first. This is our Herrerasaurus habitat, which of course we saw in the Jurassic Park, the game, the Telltale game. I'm not sure if they were ever present on Sorna. But you know what? It's meant to be if the park was successful, so why would you not transfer over some dinosaurs? And this is what I mean. The actual exhibits themselves, I'm not trying to be harsh or anything, but a lot of them are fairly chill. This, you know, this is just a very, very standard-looking Herrerasaurus habitat. But it's the other reference ones that I just think are really cool. So over here, we have our Spinosaurus habitat. And again, thanks to expanded mods, you can see we actually have the Spinosaurus next to the airfield strip from the start of Jurassic Park 3, with the towers, little buildings over here at the side, some vehicles parked up, stuff like that, which again I think is really, really cool. And there is even the plane at the end. So yeah, I mean, the map is awesome from Frontier that this stuff is in the game in the first place. I really like that. But the fact that the Spinosaurus can now wander around this area and actually interact with these items where it would have been in the start of the film, I think is awesome. Can I? Yeah. Love you, Kaio. So I can just pick up the Spinosaurus. And like, if we want it next to the smashed out plane, it gives you the feeling that the plane is maybe a little bit small, if anything. But how cool is that? I'm going to pause the game now. Actually right there next to it. I love that. I'm living for that right now. I think that's awesome. Spino looks beautiful as well. I'm just going to... It's a quick little screenshot. Actually, if I just... can I rotate? How do I rotate? Ah! Spino, I'm sorry. That's not what I wanted. No! Right, so it's not Z or X. Is it Y? It must be Y, right? Well, I've broken everything. Yeah, I just wanted to rotate it that way, so it's like looking into the plane. Okay. You ready? I mean, look at that. Very cool. Very cool. And you'll notice that the Spinosaurus is injured. And now, I don't know if this took absolutely ages, but as you can see, it's injured because it swallowed a phone. So it's actually swallowed the phone. It's got that Jurassic Park 3 reference as part of it. And that's what we've heard in the past. Does it make the tune every now and again, or did I imagine that in a fever dream? I believe it makes the tune every now and again, but it could have been a fever dream. So what else do we have? Over here, we've got a reference to the start of the Lost World. It might not look like it instantly. Here we have our Tyrannosaurus Rexes down by the coastline, which, wait, what did he say? He said they would be at the coast, right? Because that's where the bigger dinosaurs wouldn't be. So it's just kind of circumventing what Paul Kirby said, but there we go. We've got our book and dough, etc., etc. And over here, we have some comic deficits, because we're by the beach, of course. That's the opening to the Lost World Jurassic Park, with the whole... Not that you can ever see the bloody compies, but we're by the beach. That's the opening to the Lost World Jurassic Park with Ian Malcolm. One of my favourite openings to a film ever, by the way. It's worth mentioning. It's totally weird stuff, but with the girl screaming and it cuts to Ian, and he's just standing there yawning. I think it's brilliant. It's nonsense, but it's brilliant. Over here, we've got a big old lagoon. With some, there we go, Tylosaurus, of course, because this is, again, a reference to Jurassic Park, the game. And as you can see, this is something we did, of course, in our Biodome series, very much inspired by the same thing, although I don't know why I didn't use a Tylosaurus. But when we drop into the water, you can see here that we've got these underwater viewing areas, exactly like what I did. I'm not saying it was copied or that I invented it, lots of people have done it before, I'm sure. It's a really cool idea. And that is more reminiscent of Jurassic Park, the game, with the underwater dome viewing thingamajiggy, and that is our Tylosaurus, which we need a good Tylosaurus mod to bring them more in line with the JP the game versions. But obviously that aspect of modding is not quite working at this point in time, but maybe down the line, eh? God, they are ugly as sin, aren't they? I haven't looked at the default Tylosaurus in a very long time. It is hideous. I don't dislike it necessarily. I think the buck teeth are maybe a little bit too much. It's a very British dinosaur. Right. It's kind of just the far too obvious joke. And I'm British, so. Over here, we've got a bunch of dinosaurs. We've got Compsognathus again. We've got Stegosauruses. We've got Triceratopses. Initially, it looks a bit weird. It's basically this tour on the monorail station that goes over this little island, so you can watch the dinosaurs as you go past. What I'm assuming this is meant to be is meant to be reminiscent of when they fly over the island at the start of Jurassic Park 3, and Alan Grant's narrating things, he's pointing out the dinosaurs out the window. We see Jurassic Park 3's absolutely hideous Triceratops from the sky and stuff like that, so I'm assuming that's the idea. The Stegos and the Trikes are meant to be what Kirby and that lot see as they fly over the island. And then we start to go a bit lower. They talk about the landing strip, and Grant gets annoyed, and yada, yada, yada. Over here, we've got a little hotel section overlooking the beach, and that's right by the park entrance. So we've got the visitor center over here. We've got some little Main Street shopping areas over here, and this is the actual arrival point here, which is really nice, actually. What are these? Ah! Oh, that's... Yeah, that's the... Oh, that's cool. I like that. That's the new things from the... Oh, man. Oh, look, awesome. That's the new things from the new decorations from the lagoon. And if you sink them into the ground a little bit, you can, you know, use them as pillars next to your Jurassic Park pillars. These, however, I'd say the Jurassic Park ones are... They should be facing the same way, but that's just personal preference. But still, very cool. I like that a lot. So we've got, like, a Main Street area. Spino skeleton, of course, right in front of the visitor center. Absolutely perfect. We've got the San Diego thing. Oh, look at this little park as well. Isn't that beautiful? Yeah, like the start of the bit over there, I'm not super impressed with in terms of park design, but there's some really nice stuff here. I think that looks fantastic. We've got the amphitheater over here, which is housing something. It's Baryonyx and Ceratosaurus. Not sure why, but it is. Because of course you need the Ceratosaurus at the very least. There is one more, however. I've not shown you my favourite reference quite yet. We're getting there very soon. We've got our Mementosaurus from the Lost World. We've got a Parasaurus and Corys. Hideously ugly Corythosaurus. One of my least favourite dinosaur designs in the entire franchise. It's very much up there. But again, this is kind of a little bit reminiscent of the game trail from the Lost World. And then we get over here, we get to the aviary. So we've got two aviaries. Well, I'll show you those in a sec, because those are my favourite things. What else we got over here? We've got another beach habitat here with the Brachiosauruses down by the beach. Look at them strolling around in the water. Doesn't that look really cool? That looks really nice. I think there's maybe too many Brachis. I'd have dialed it back, personally. I probably would have got rid of four of them, actually. But still, I think that looks awesome. Having the exhibit actually in the water really just makes that feel super dramatic. I love that. Definitely something I want to play around with a bit more on my expanded maps. Over here, we've got a tour vehicle thingamajiggy, which heads down here, and that's got a ton of different dinosaurs. So we've got Mosasaurus, we've got Gallimimus, we've got Mosasaurus, we've got tons of Mosasaurus. This is basically hell for me. Oh, and we've got Apatosaurus and Ankylosaurus, which again, as you can see, themed after the Jurassic Park 3 version. Right here in this sort of, it's quite a nice little area actually, in the nook of the mountain. Right, so that's most of the park. There's other little things, but that's most of it. But we've got two aviaries. So we've got one over here, filled with Geostenbergia. I don't know why. I would have picked... What was it? What's the pterosaur? Let me check. Fume Gully is really interesting for some reason. I'm just gonna build a quick thingy. Hatchery. That's fine. Sierodactylus, because Sierodactylus was the pterosaur, I should say, that was meant to be in Jurassic Park. It was in the novel for Jurassic Park, and then of course was replaced by Pteranodon in the film. So I really done that rather than Geostenbergia. But this is not the one I love. So we've got a little aviary down there, and then you go up the hill, as you can see, past this lovely I love that. They've ramped off and built a little hill underneath underneath the parachute. With Ben Hildebrand, well, his corpse hanging under there, assumedly. Anyways, you go up the hill, which, yeah, this is the kind of thing, I mean, Disney's neating it out. I feel I have to be... Look, I really love this map, but I feel I can be a little bit critical here and there. This is messy. But this, I think, is very, very cool. So we've got our aviary here, this really awesome-looking decoration bit here with this big fountain display and all the pterosaurs circling around the rocks. That looks absolutely awesome. But the best thing is inside. So this is obviously meant to resemble the aviary from Jurassic Park 3. And what they've done is they've stacked up the rocks using modding tools, and then they've connected all the cages together, again, using the modding tools, using the toolbox that Kyle Denick brought out, to make the aviary pathways from Jurassic Park 3. I just think that's a really, really nice idea. It would have been even cooler if maybe we had like a little bridge or something. I don't know what you would make that out of, though. I think I've considered that in the past and realized that there just isn't anything you can make a bridge out of. But I think a bridge connecting two sides of this would be cool. But look at that. That connects over there into the viewing tower. That's awesome. Really, really like this as an idea. I think that's very, very clever. And definitely an idea I will be stealing for my own playthroughs. Yeah, that's great. That's a perfect example of how being willing to use mods. And I totally get why people don't want to play with mods, yada, yada, yada. But this is a good example of why sometimes using mods can just let you do slightly crazy things. Or very cool things that you wouldn't have been able to do otherwise. I think it's a really nice idea. Big, big fan of that. Let me just have a little peek in decos. I don't think there is anything you could use as a bridge. There's nothing like... I guess you could like put some containers up. Imagine you had like... Right, can I have like a flat area? Is that going to work? I think that would work. I think that would be quite cool, actually. I might do this in my own thing. Sorry, I'm kind of going off topic. But that, and then you'd have the cages on both sides, and it's kind of like a bridge connecting across. You know, just to get that bit from Jurassic Park 3 with the mist on the walkway. But yeah, really, just some really nice ideas. Really cool integration of the films into everything. Got another beach, little hotel area there. Lots and lots of work gone into it. It's really cool. It's really cool. I'm a really big fan. And definitely some inspiration here we may take on and use on our own builds and stuff like that in the future. But look at that. Isn't that awesome? Yeah. Good stuff. So that was, again, by Dr. Squatch / Ratsmacker 3050. Definitely go check out the mod, the map, Jurassic Park Sorna on the Nexus. It does require a bunch of different mods, but they're all listed as the requirements, and they really are. They're the kind of default mods you should all have. If you're playing with mods, they're the kind of default mods you should probably have in your game, mainly cryogenic stuff and some ILO dev stuff, yada, yada, yada. Yeah, gonna go. But yeah, I'm really, really big fan. Definitely go check it out. And if, obviously, you don't want to play with mods or you're on console or something, then you've got my video. So you're a lucky duck either way, aren't you? A lucky, lucky duck. Right, thank you so much for joining me. Go give some love to the map maker. It's good stuff. And throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. I will see you lovely, jubbly people very, very soon. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much love as always. Bye-bye.